I got to fish Lake Mead one last time before I moved to Kentucky. Might be the last time I ever fish Lake Mead in my life. I don't know. My guess is that at some point I will come back out to Las Vegas to visit. The question is, am I going to be able to get out and fish on Lake Mead again? I hope I am able to, because that is one thing that I'm really going to miss. I've really got to really like, more or less love, fishing on Lake Mead. You know, there's certain places where the potential to catch fish is very high, and you catch good numbers of fish. So it's a lot of fun. And I met two guys that, you know, unfortunately, I only got to go out with a few times. One of them only twice. Maybe a third time tomorrow. We'll see. And then the other guy, you know, five or six, seven times. Just real nice guys who, you know, give you anything out of their tackle box, anything out of their cooler, you know, as far as like a snack, and don't expect anything in return. You know, just enjoy the company of someone who shares the passion for fishing. So, little bummed that I'm leaving that, you know, the potential to create relationships with people that share a hobby, but they're guys that are, I definitely try and hit up if I come back out and visit. The day went pretty well considering it was crazy windy. The day started off with 12 to 14 mile an hour winds out of the south and just slowly built all day long. We showed up with two boats, but only ended up taking one out because it was so windy to start. We just decided it would make most sense and probably be the safest to all just pile into the bigger boat, the 22 footer that, you know, is made to handle rough water. It just fishes better in general. So we ended up catching fish, and I actually lost what I think was probably my personal best off of Lake Mead on a Senko or a Yum Dinger. It's freaking road, the Las Vegas 215 is horrible. Bouncing everywhere, can't see nothing. But anyways, I threw up into some weeds and some grass, and actually I threw the bait up on the bank unintentionally. I had the wind at my back. Like I said, it was like 20 mile an hour winds, and as soon as that thing hit the water, he grabbed it and I set the hook, and man, he got wrapped in some submerged brush, and the boil he made after I set the hook on him was pretty decent. So it made me think that fish was 3 pounds plus. My biggest out of Lake Mead is 3.6, so he may have been bigger than that. I don't know. But he wrapped, and I made the mistake of, you know, letting the line slack to see if he would pull himself free. And I think if I'd have just kept it tight and kept him pinned, I think he would have worked himself free. But the hook popped and actually came back with a little chunk of his lip, so he twisted himself free. But I did end up catching a decent little largemouth, and I caught a striper early on top water despite the crazy wind, and two other guys caught stripers, so really can't complain. Not much of a fishing video, but it's something, and you know, again, it's my last time, maybe forever, fishing Lake Mead. We'll see. Hopefully I'll get to get out on it a couple more times before I go 6 feet under, I guess. Yeah.
Joel hooked up on the striper with a chatterbait. Pull him up. Nice. There we go.
What's that?
There's probably another one following him. Nice, dude. Sweet. Chatterbait. All right, Joel hooked up. He's got braid. That is a good fish. Oh, dude. Dude, that's like 2.5-3 pounds. Sweet. Dude, let's come back. Let's get a weight on that.